Yeah.
Okay, it's been another week or so since the previous vlog. We're about to turn into Petit airfield here. We were going to pick up the wing that was completely redone for us. So thanks to KFA for that. And yeah, we're going to pick it up and take it to Warmbaths and then put it back onto the plane. After loading our newly recovered and repainted wing on the trailer, we joined the KFA guys who were holding their monthly breakfast fly-in. We caught up with other KFA pilots, enjoyed a complimentary coffee and booty roll, and then departed to Warmbaths with our wing. We finally finished the luggage bay enlargement. We used strong but lightweight aluminium for the rear braces and then recovered the backside with the same piece of fabric and used silvered plywood for the sides. The area shown here is the baggage space gained, which I roughly estimate to be around 35 to 40 liters of additional space, which is considerable in a plane of this size and is a big improvement to this plane's utility. The assembling of the engine components has also progressed, with carbs fitted and radiators mounted. Another upgrade we decided on was to install navigation and strobe lights, which will increase our visibility to other aircraft in the air.
And the wing is back on.
And with that, another day was gone, with quite a bit of progress made.
Okay, we're at Warmbaths airfield. Let's see what's cooking.
A hot coffee and watching airplanes take off. Not a bad way to start a day. We were delighted to see that finally the cowling fits around the engine. It even fully closes now. We sourced a wood comp propeller, which is supposed to be quite efficient, but real world results remains to be seen. Seeing as the cowling now fits, the necessary modifications needed to be made to allow for cooling of the radiator, as well as a place to mount the landing lights, we decided to add. And of course, it needs to be repainted. We were all quite curious, so we decided to weigh the aircraft. It was done in a very crude manner by using a bathroom scale. Coming in at 296 kilograms, it seems to have lost about 20 kilograms, which isn't quite possible. Either the previous weight imbalance was done wrong, or our quick and dirty attempt wasn't accurate. Admittedly, there was a few bits and bobs that still needed to be fitted, like a choke cable, the cowling and spinner paint, as well as unusable fuel like the header tank's 5 liters, which was empty for our test. That all will add at least 5 more kilograms, maybe more. I'll report back in a future video with an accurate empty weight. Be sure to look out for part 3 of this series, where we finally take the upgraded Bushbaby flying.